In this video, we're going to deal with positional encoding. Now, that is a way to inject relative position information of tokens into your deep learning model. It's very essential for training of large language models. In fact, that was also done in the paper Attention is All You Need, that introduces the self-attention and transformer architectures. And so this is one thing we're going to go over here. For example, if you have a sequence of words that you want to bring into your large language model, either during training or during inference, what usually happens is that this is converted into a token sequence, and that is a sequence of numbers that represent these tokens. And then these tokens get converted into their embeddings. So you end up with this matrix of n tokens to the dimension of the embedding. And if you want to add now information about the position, then what is helpful is if you have some function that maps a position number, such as the fourth token in the sequence, into that new tensor that has the same dimension as the embedding. And one way to do that is this particular positional encoding formula here that was also used in the paper Attention is All You Need. I've linked that here, where these trigonometric functions are used, sine and cosine. There's different handling for even and odd numbers. That's where these counters come up here. So that incrementer I goes from between 0 and d half, where d is the dimension of your encoded output. So if you're want to match the embedding space and the embedding dimension is 100, that D should be 100. And the position is the position of the token. So again, first token is 1, second token is 2, and so on and so forth. And if you compute these functions and put that all together, you'll end up with that D-dimensional vector. You see this number 10,000 here, that is almost arbitrarily chosen. It just needs to be some high number, so we're also going to be using that. And in this next module, I'm going to show you how to implement this in PyTorch. First, I'm going to just run these cells that would install the dependencies you need, torch, and then later we're going to plot something with matplotlib. And now here, I go about building that module. So inherits from NN module, and when I construct it, I pass in the desired output dimension. I make that an attribute of the class. I'll also set that number n to these 10,000 here. And then we're going to see what this forward operation exactly does. So position, let's say this was the number of your position, or it was an array with all these positions, then this would go in and would come out with these positional encoding. And so we're going to do exactly what is shown here, right? There's an even number that I'm showing here. It's a range going from what I've shown here, 0 to dimension divided by 2, but then actually twice that in steps of 2. And for the odd numbers, I'm just adding that plus 1 here. I'm doing a little bit of reshaping using view, and then it repeats by the number of position because we're going to align it with the dimension, or like the length of that position encoding. So if we run that, also just kind of adding that singleton dimension to position, and then do the sine and cosine here, as well as the 10,000 to the power of exactly these incrementers here, then and then put it basically all together by creating that output matrix and then filling in even and odd numbers, then we have exactly that implementation. There are other ways to implement that. Some of them might even be a little bit more compact. They're not as easy to follow. You need some more advanced skills for that, but this is one way of doing that. But it all comes out to the same thing. So now we can run a example. Let's say the output dimension we envision is 100. The sequence length of what we're feeding in is, for example, 200 tokens. And so I'm creating that object, and then I'm just creating some positions here and of that sequence length, and then I'm running it. And what comes out is exactly what I would expect, basically 200 rows because it's a sequence length, and then 100 dimensions of embedding space. And now we can actually envision that. So in this block here, I'm just picking three different token positions here and just see what the dimensions look like. So in this 100 dimensional space, each of these numbers is basically a number, and in between we have that connecting line. But that gives you kind of like for each position this vector of numbers here, and they're well normalized between -1 and 1. And you see they kind of, if they're similar in position, they're close by each other. If they're different in position, they differ quite a bit from one another. Another way to also visualize is really nice is by doing this color map here. I've seen that similar being done in one good blog that was explaining it. I put here the position on the x-axis and the dimension on the y-axis, but you see it's kind of that how it evolves over space. Now, in one of my future videos, I'm going to show you how to use these positional encodings in, for example, stable diffusion algorithms, because that is also where position comes in. So, but yeah, for now, this video is done as an introduction to this concept. You'll find the code in the GitHub that I'm linking, and I look forward to seeing you in one of the next lectures. Thanks for watching.